Good morning, Elwyn Reading Corner. Good morning. This is Carrie, and I hope you're following directions by wearing your mask still. It's important more than ever. But I'm gonna remove my mask so we can enjoy our book today. Let me put my glasses on, not for safety, but for actual necessity, because I can't see our book without it. Now, I decided to choose Amelia Bedelia by Peggy Parrish, and the pictures are by Fritz Siebel. So here's the book, and there's quite a few sequels or quite a few editions, so I know some of our other staff members are looking forward to reading this particular book, and I hope you guys like it. So here we go, Amelia Bedelia. Let's see if there starts. There really isn't a reasoning behind it. Okay. Let's see if you guys can see our page. Okay. Oh, Amelia Bedelia, the first day of work. Now, let me back up real quick. This is going to be a book basically of listening to instructions. All day, every day, someone else, or maybe even you, are given instructions, or you're asking someone to do something. That is called an instruction. You might ask someone, could you please give me the ketchup? Or could you hand me a napkin? Or your mom and dad will ask you to say, please go wash your hands, or place your mask on. Things like that, those are instructions. So listen for the instructions throughout this whole book and see what you would have done. And I hope you enjoy it. Here we go. Oh, Amelia Bedelia, the first day of work, and I can't be here, but I must make a list for you. Do just what the list says, Mrs. Rogers asked. Mrs. Rogers got in the car and Mr. Rogers, and they drove off. There they go. There's even a little dog in the car. Do you see it right there? Super cute. So she's waving, off they go. All right, first day of work, I guess, Mrs. Rogers. What nice folks. I'm going to like working here myself, said Amelia Bedelia. Here's the list. It looks pretty long here on the table. And her exact words were what? Do exactly what's on the list. Amelia Bedelia went inside. What such a grand house. They must be very rich folks. But I must get right to work. Here I stand just looking, and me with the whole list of things to do. Amelia Bedelia stood there, not a minute longer. I think I make a surprise for them. I'll make a lemon meringue pie. I do make a very good lemon meringue pie. Does anyone else enjoy a lemon meringue? I know I do. Matter of fact, I'm wearing lemon pants. So Amelia Bedelia went into the kitchen. So she put a little of this and a pinch of that, placed it into a bowl, and she mixed it up. She rolled it out. She got super busy right away. Soon the pie was ready to go right into the oven. And there goes Amelia Bedelia. Voila, she's done. Now, where's that list? Amelia Bedelia starts to read. Right off the bat, change towels in the green bathroom. Amelia Bedelia found the green bathroom with those very nice towels. She thought, why change them? But what were the instructions, guys? Do exactly what's on the list. Here we go. Then Amelia Bedelia remembered Mrs. Rogers' words. She must do what she was told. Well, all right, Amelia Bedelia said. She got some scissors and a snip here and a little snip there, and she changed those towels. There, said Amelia Bedelia. She looked at the list again. Dust the furniture. Did you ever hear tell such a silly thing? At my house, we undust the furniture. But each their own. Amelia Bedelia took one last look at the bathroom and saw a big box with words on it. Dusting powder. Right on the box. It was right there in front of her. Well, look at that. A special powder for dust. Huh. So Amelia Bedelia dusts her furniture that she be dusted enough. And how nice did everything smell? Who knew? Dusting the furniture. The next on the list, draw the drapes when the sun comes in. Read Amelia Bedelia. She looked up. The sun was coming in. Amelia Bedelia looked at the list again. Draw the drapes. That's what it says. I'm not much of a hand drawing person, but I'll try. We should call our staff member, our supervisor, Twee, in. I bet she could do a good job at this task, drawing the drapes. So Amelia Bedelia got right with it, sat down, and she drew the drapes. She's not doing a bad job. Amelia Bedelia marked off about the drapes, and now what? Huh. Put the lights out when you finish in the living room. Amelia Bedelia thought for a minute. She switched off the lights. Then she carefully unscrewed the bulbs. You notice she's putting all the bulbs in her arms in a basket. And Amelia Bedelia put the lights out. So things need to be aired out too, just like pillows. Oh, do you have a lot to learn? Gosh, everyone does things so differently in each household. My pie, exclaimed Amelia Bedelia. My pie! She hurried to the kitchen. Just right then, she said, I took the pie out of the oven and put it on the table to cool. She started to go back to the list. Measure 2 cups of rice is the next task. Amelia Bedelia found 2 cups she filled with rice. Amelia Bedelia measured the rice. Oh my goodness. She put them in coffee mugs. There are 2 of them. There's 2 cups. And she got a measuring tape. I'm not thinking that was the plan. Amelia Bedelia laughed at these folks. Do exactly what the list says. She poured it back into the container and placed it back in the cupboard. Man, to each their own. The meat market will deliver the steak and the chicken. Please trim the fat before you put the steak and the chicken in the icebox. Please dress the chicken when the meat arrive. Amelia Bedelia opened the bag and she looked at the steak for a long time. She said. This will do nicely. Amelia Bedelia got some lace and a bit of ribbon, and Amelia Bedelia trimmed the fat. And before she put the steak in the icebox, now she must dress the chicken. I wonder if she wants pants. Is he a he chicken or a she chicken? Said Amelia Bedelia. She went right to work. Soon the chicken was finished. Amelia Bedelia heard the door open. The folks are back, she said. She rushed out to meet them. Wow, they look lovely. Oh, I love their fur jacket and their hat, all their matching outfits. So handsome. Amelia Bedelia went right for the light bulbs outside and asked Mr. Rogers. Just like the list said, I put the lights out, said Amelia Bedelia. I didn't stay to bring them back in. They didn't get air too long, I'm sure. Amelia Bedelia, the sun will fade the furniture. I asked you to draw the drapes, Mrs. Rogers yelling. But I did. See, right here. She holds up her lovely picture. Don't you guys think? Oh, I don't think Mrs. Rogers understood her. Then Mrs. Rogers saw the furniture. Oh, no! My furniture, she cried. Did I dust it well enough, Amelia Bedelia? It's such a nice dusting powder. Mr. Rogers went to wash his hands. I say, he called. These are very unusual towels. Mrs. Rogers dashed into the bathroom. Oh no, my best hand towels. I did change them. I didn't change them enough, Mrs. Umbelia Bedelia asked. Mrs. Rogers went to the kitchen. I'll cook dinner. Where's the rice? Oh, I measured it for you and I placed it right back in the box. It was perfectly 2 cups. Did I not do that right? But wait, was the meat delivered? Mrs. Rogers asked. Oh, yes, Amelia Bedelia replied. I did. I trimmed the fat just like you said. Doesn't it look lovely? Mrs. Rogers rushed to the ice box and opened it. Oh no, lace and ribbon, Mrs. Rogers said. The chicken, you dressed the chicken, Mrs. Rogers said. Yes, I found the nicest box to put him in, said Amelia Bedelia. In a box? Mrs. Rogers hurried over to the box and lifted the lid and laid the chicken dressed. He just couldn't be more fabulous. Mrs. Rogers was angry. Mrs. Rogers was very angry. Mrs. Rogers meant to tell Mrs. Amelia Bedelia she was fired. She really wanted to say, Amelia Bedelia, this isn't going to work out. We're going to have to ask you to leave. But before she could get any more words out of her mouth because she was so angry, Mr. Rogers put something in her mouth. Mrs. Rogers opened her mouth, closed her mouth, and it was so good. Mrs. Rogers forgot about how angry she was. All she cared about was having their lemon meringue pie. So basically, when listening to instructions, there are lots of different ways to learn and listen. So if you feel a little confused or you may not understand the instruction, it is okay to ask for a little more directions, a little more assistance. All right. I hope you enjoyed the book, and we'll see you at the next reading. Have a great day. Be safe. Wear your mask.